Sometimes we talk of some of the concepts. What security are we talking about? Maybe in this room, there are those who believe security is defense. Maybe in this room, some people may believe security is intelligence. Maybe in this room, people may believe that security is safety. So we may be having a different perspective of when we talk about security. And this is one of the key challenges for a nation to have a common understanding when we talk about security. This is how I would like to organize myself. But before I will start, I just want to make sure how many of your countries are having national security strategy.
Sure. Many? Let me help you.
Okay. So I assume that we know what do we mean by national security strategy. But let me ask a different question. How many of you having defense strategy? Or white paper? Okay. How many of you are having counterterrorism strategy? And how many of you are having maritime security? Okay.
Six.
Just another question. To what level are you confident that your country is delivering security to the citizen? Is delivering security to the citizen. No volunteer? To what level are you confident that your country is delivering security to its citizen? Definitely, this is very important. That's why I asked first, what is the security? And it seems as if all of you have agreed that you have your own security. But that's not the debate. The debate is the complexity we are talking about. It is so complex. And that's why we may be thinking about one thing, but we are talking about different things. Maybe this is why I would like to start with this session. First, we in Africa Center, in order to understand the landscape of security on the continent, we said the best way is to have to map out what is really existing on the continent. And we've developed case studies, about 9 case studies, most of them are with you, to gauge what is really available on the continent. And with those ones, this will help us to talk about what security is talking about in Africa. We use about 4 lenses to assess the status of security or of the strategy in Africa. One is the product itself. The product, it is the document I have been asking about. Do you have national security in your countries? Do you have defense security? Is the strategy? Do you have internal security or maritime security? Our assessment, we found out most African countries, they do not have national security. What some, most of them, they have sectoral security strategies. Very few. And if those security documents are available, are conducted in such a way, not inclusive, and not involving the citizens. And this is very important because when we talk about whose security you are talking about, if it is about security of citizens, then the issue of a document not to be available to the citizen. So this is what we found, that most African countries, they do not have national security strategies. On the other side, there are a lot of opportunities for us to have such a document. African Union, they have what is called the African Union Common Framework, a policy on defense and security. And that framework is a common policy framework. It's actually asking the member state, all the member state, they committed themselves that they will be developing an inclusive and participatory national security strategy. So that's the commitment you have. It is not something being for you being asked to. So we have a commitment already to develop your own national security strategies. But in fact, ECOWAS has even gone further with affirmative commitment to develop that type of national security strategy at the level of the region. So this is about the product. The second one is about the process itself. As I said, many studies have shown on the national security strategies that the process is more important than the product itself, the way you conduct it. Most of the documents we have seen are usually still in the context of security is untouchable. It is only classified, a lot of secrecy, and it is a no-zone area for the civilian. And by so it suggests a process or whereby people are not involved, then it is clear case this document cannot be implemented and may not be appealing to the citizen. What are the opportunities? Opportunities is just the mindset that we start engaging today. And that's why the session on governance was a very important. To what level can we change our mind to think strategically, but importantly to be a change agent in terms of bringing a real change in this sector, which is very important. And there's a commitment by the African Union. Such a process must involve the people and the citizens. It's not something coming from nowhere. It's coming from within Africa, from African Union. Then the people, most of the documents we have seen are state-centric process documents, are not people-centered. If you decide that we are talking about human security, there's no doubt when we talk about human security, we are talking whose security are we talking about? We are talking people's security. But indeed, people's security means also the state security, societal security, but importantly, human security. So this transition to have a better understanding of security as citizen, centrally, I think is very important. Priorities. What we have seen in some of these strategies available is that the security landscape is changing and evolving, becoming very complex. That may require for you to prioritize. Without that, when you're coming, everything is priority. And this requires a lot of issue of leadership, a lot of commitment, thinking. Some of these documents we have found listing these priorities, but not having a lot of discussion about how can you prioritize this security, the priorities in terms of the security. Partnership. We have seen from these documents, and especially through the security sector reform, in most cases externally driven. In most cases, countries are not committing resources to own those documents. So becoming alien documents, not actually ensuring national ownership. So this is how we map based on the case studies. Then we are asking ourselves why, what is happening? It is what we call the capability trap. Is that we are doing the same thing, not iterative in order to learn from it. We are repeating the same mistake of failing to deliver security with the same institution. And the more we inject it, the same, we do the same, we are actually even creating insecurity. We are not changing the way we have been delivering. And it will take us years and years for us to break this cycle, this trap. And that's why this idea of critical thinking and for leadership to be a change agent, I think becoming very important for you to get out of this. But let me highlight some of these few points, although you have talked about them. You have been talking about them. These important elements that are very important for any success, and that are so linked together. One, values, and I think many of you have talked about this issue of values. And I think one of the most important is that to dig to our values that actually lead us to exist as people on the continent. A leader that's equipped with these values that are actually related to the people is one of the sources of success. I will talk a bit about this issue of values. And then the strategy, I think people talk about it, and then the issue of principles. But let me echo what Raymond said. National security strategy is about theory of change. And I just want to highlight some of the points that he mentioned. One, it is about a step-by-step approach. It helps you to identify and break down a problem into a root causes, identify entry points, and search for possible solution, take action, reflect from what you have learned, adapt, and then act again. And this is a very important exercise. This is very important to highlight when we are talking about national security strategy development. It is about a theory of change. With a critical thinking in order to approach the problem. And you learn from the problem. And act based on, and even appreciate your mistakes. Make your mistakes to be opportunities for bringing a change. Now, I'm just going through this one, just passing by, values. Values are extremely important before you embark on developing national security strategies. What are the things that are so unique with you? Most of these values sometimes are in the constitutions, in the preamble of the constitution. Let me give you an example of Kenya. Kenya, they provided in the constitution and the head of the president to report about the status of these values to the parliament. It is extremely important. These values are the one going to guide you when developing national security strategy. National interests, also very important. Sometimes they're existing, make use of them before you start developing national security strategy. Because these are the things which, because everything, this is strategy to enhance your national interests. Because besides the fact also of achieving your national security objectives. These are two things I want you to keep in mind. Let me go now just to the process. And the diagram I'm sharing with you, we developed based on the case studies, a lot of discussion with our partners like Shets and Kenneth. And also we had a good meeting in Gaborone. And in that meeting we agreed what should be the phases of national security strategy. But these phases may differ from one country to another. I want to highlight. The first phase is initiation. How can you initiate a national security strategy? There are some aspects that I want to highlight. One, what is the entry point? What would trigger a country to say, yes, I want to start developing a national security strategy? There are some opportunities available. One, sometimes it could be security sector reform. That could actually recommend that you need to have a national security strategy. Or it could be sometimes peace agreement in some context. Or even a legislation that telling the executive that you need to develop national security strategy. Or a political leadership. A leadership coming in and stating that they want, that leader, he or she wants to have a national security strategy. Or a budgeting process. Or an institutional audit. And I think we have good cases whereby some of the, for example, South Africa did a very important work looking at the intelligence, internal security, and defense. And all these assessments, this audit resulted by saying that we need to develop their own national security strategy. So the most important thing is to identify the entry points. Second, is who to initiate the national security strategy. There are a lot of options. But most of the practice is that the head of state, in order to ensure ownership, should be the one to initiate it. There are some countries that actually the parliament initiate this process. But it is the best practice is that let the head of state to be the one, especially the executive, to be the one initiating it. And then the other one, what should be the purpose and scope? It should be quite strict and very clear. A concise purpose and scope and methodology should be real cleared out by the authority concerned. The other one is that we have seen, because national security strategy development is a big thing, you may need to designate an authority or institution. In the case of Senegal, they designated sheikhs, and in case of Niger, they designated kenes. And these institutions are part of the government. They're just like a think tank. And what is good, they have been tasked to look after in developing national security strategy. Sometimes people, they put it into the office of the president, sometimes the national security advisor, but it is better that you have an independent institution that would allow the discussion and dialogue, like the experience of Senegal. Then the last one on this initiation, the drafting committee. It has become a very important practice that such a process not only to include the institutions of security sector, but the other stakeholders, and especially women and the civil society. And it is for the good of the process to be inclusive by having this element in the drafting committee. So that's one initiation. The second one, pre-drafting key steps. After initiation, you need to have a specific step and action. And this is based on our experience. It is important to start with technical exposure of the team or the institution entrusted. And that exposure will allow you to develop a very comprehensive roadmap of how national security research development should look like in terms of communication, in terms of resources even. And I think it's very important the issue of technical exposure, because and you learn from the experience from other countries. The other actions also is the review of your security sector. You have to take stock of the security sector itself. And I think this is even a commitment by the African Union. The institutional audit and review of the sector is very important, a good starting point. Then the drafting and consultation. This is phase number three. Few things I want to highlight. After having a review of your security sector, you'll be able now to have what we call the zero draft. A zero draft could be in consultation with the key stakeholders. After having the zero draft, you may need to subject it this one for the consultation at all levels of the government. Don't forget even the local level. Some of the practice consultations, some people start collecting a specific aspect of the zero draft and then become a basis for the consultation. After that, well, there will be different views, you reconcile the document. After the reconciliation of the document, now that document, you can now take it for the adoption and approval. There's some debate about this adoption and approval. The practice is showing that it is better don't subject it to the approval of the parliament. Let it be flexible. Take it to the parliament for acknowledgement. But let the executive itself be the one approving it. But take it to the parliament for acknowledgement and to ensure the issue of national ownership. And then implementation, the last phase, is the dissemination and communication. Maybe I will discuss with you later on because my time is a bit... But there are two things I need you to know. The whole exercise, you need to have a very comprehensive communication and dissemination strategy. Because it's a sector that is very, very difficult to get into. You need a political leadership. And that's why it's very important to have that strategy. And those consultations could take a different level. Maybe I will discuss with you later on those ones. And the last stage is the implementation. Implementation, I want to highlight a few points. The practice is that you don't need to have the actual implementation for the strategy. What you need to have is to provide guidelines of how to develop sectoral strategies. Because national security like to provide the framework. The sectoral strategy are the tools with which you can implement the national security strategy. And then provide implementation metrics and develop mechanism for monitoring and periodic review. So these are some of the we'll discuss more about this. But let me just conclude with this. I'm putting here some of the elements for consultation in the process of developing national security strategy. One, and I think it is the issue of national security vision. National security vision is not a national vision. And it will require a lot of consultation with citizens. Second, national security interests. These are interests you need to identify, prioritize them. Third, how you can make a statement, security problem statement of your security environment by assessing the threats and opportunities. And then based on that, now you can develop your core objective that you want to achieve with your national security strategy. And then the whole lot of division of labor and assigning responsibilities. This one may need technical expertise rather than just a consultation. And then how can you mobilize resources? As I said, resources are left for the sectorial strategies. These are the ones going to implement it, than you implement the year. And the last one, maybe we talk about it, the whole lot of civilian oversight. So let me stop here and thank you. I have to talk about partnership, but I will talk later. Thank you very much.